At 195, we have Trent Schultz and Corey Bigby. At 220 pounds, Brent Hildebrand and Ethan Balchek. At 285, we have Nico Gonzalez and Colin Lavelle. Under 6 pounds, we have Open and Golden Eagles and Isaiah Atencio. At 113 pounds, we have Aiden Weaver and Caleb Atencio.
What opportunity.
At 120 pounds, we have Lon Ingram and Gage Valdez. At 126 pounds, we have Preston Weaver and Dustin Mervin. At 132 pounds, we have Roger Meyer and Zane Valdez. At 138 pounds, we have Derek Platts and Eric Crumley. At 145 pounds, we have Nolan Stretchko and David Norman. At 152 pounds, John Urban and Ethan Blake. At 160 pounds, we have Cameron Williams and Micah Strahan. And our last match of the evening will be Anders Oakland and Josh Smith. Captains and coaches at the mat, please.
I don't think so. I can hear myself when I see the person, but
Schultz and Corey Bigby from the Titans.
Let's go, Corey!
Mr. Golden Eagle, Ben Hildebrand, Titans head, Ethan Belichick.
Your feet going.
At 106 pounds, open for Golden Eagles Titans Isaiah Atencio.
Go in!
Go in!
Hi, my name is Jake Torres, and welcome to the Mountain Vista wrestling match against Legend. I'm here with my co-star,
Grayson Coinsen.
And sorry about that, the match is starting late on our end with audio. We are having some technical difficulties. Good footwork. What you've missed so far is two matchups, a couple takedowns went down. Ooh, good reversal. Going down for the legs.
All he has to do is snap it right now.
He's trying to get his legs out from underneath him. Mountain Vista just won't stop fighting. Ooh. And a point for Legend.
And that was just a huge reversal.
One minute, 6 seconds left. Score is tied, 18-18. Here comes our next matchup. Just shook hands with the refs.
The 120 weight class, Lon Ingram.
Tussled his hair there. Both players fighting to get a good hold on the other opponent. Tried for the reversal. Both players are in stalemate. Legend tried to take him down. Legend goes for the feet again.
I got it. One of them score, one of them has to.
No points have been scored. Mount Vista with the takedown.
Nope, not yet.
Reversal.
No. One point scored for red of an escape.
Both of them fighting on the ground.
Two takedown greens.
Mount Vista trying desperately to pin
the
him.
The ref needs to call. Never mind.
The ref isn't calling it. Legend now taking
Legend
control.
Legend takes two takedowns. Reversal.
Legend going for the headlock.
Right now, Legend is holding Ingram in a cradle.
Legend has him almost pinned on the ground. Ref isn't calling it.
His back isn't technically on the mat. See right now, his shoulder blades aren't there.
I see what
now
you mean,
it is.
Yeah. Good holdout from Mountain Vista. Winner of that match is Legend. Legend now at 24 points, Mountain Vista at 18. Wrestlers enter the ring. Preston Weaver wrestling right now for Mountain Vista.
Weaver takes the takedown. It's now 2-0 with Minute.
Weaver trying to pin his opponent.
All Weaver has to do is butcher. Or
wrestler setting up again. Weaver going for the legs. Opponent tries to go for his legs. Weaver pin. Weaver gets a hold of him. Trying to take him down.
Weaver takes two takedown.
Weaver trying to pin his opponent.
Snap his arm. In order to weave his power.
His opponent guesses he's trying to escape.
Into a cradle.
Seconds left.
Watch his knee.
Preston trying to pin his opponent. Gets left. He grabs his right arm. Just right leg down. Right. 20 seconds left on the clock.
Preston has his opponent. Someone's leg
Preston
twisted in order
trying
to try
get his opponent down. 10
power.
Seconds left.
He's taking his right arm. He's going to try to
Three
now
seconds.
Hold a guillotine.
2-1. So, Grayson, I understand you're the team manager of the wrestling team. How is this? How are these matchups compared to the ones you've seen thus far this season?
I feel like this match we're doing pretty well. I feel like this match right now, we're doing really well, especially with the seniors. They know that this is their last home match of their high school careers. So I feel like they're really pushing towards it, and they're really improving.
You think that they'll keep fighting until the end?
Oh, yeah. They're strong and incredibly good at wrestling. They know what they're doing.
Well, I would hope they were incredibly good at wrestling.
Yes.
We go back now to the ring. Preston Weaver trying to pin his opponent again.
Preston Weaver actually qualified for state last year, and I assume that he will be aspiring to go to state with Trent Schultz, Brayden Mogg, and Nolan Strichko as well, as well as many of the other varsity wrestlers.
Do you believe that they'll continue in college?
I believe Trent will, and Preston will. I'm not 100% sure about the other.
I can see that. Preston, for sure, his match tonight has definitely been one of the most active we've seen.
Yes.
That's for sure.
Yes. Trent usually just pins his opponents because he's that good. He's a state champion.
Trent has the speed, too.
Mm-hmm. He's got the speed. And unlike a lot of state champions, a lot of them are just super aggressive. And Trent's not like that. He's aggressive, but he knows how to wrestle. A lot of them just know how to fight, and they don't know how to wrestle. Trent's good at that.
It's very interesting. We go back to Preston Weaver's match. 40 seconds left on the clock. Preston desperately trying to pin his opponent, or at least get him down on the ground again. Preston does it. Once again, trying to
Preston
pin his opponent.
Preston has regained power. He's trying to
he's grabbing
his
opponent's legs.
With his legs.
Very specific. Lots of leg work here. Preston is then, once again, trying to force his opponent's whole body onto the ground. He has his feet locked with his, and he's desperately fighting for that control over his opponent.
With this position, he's just trying to be able to, like, imbalance his opponent right now.
Left time.
Green chooses neutral position for the last period of the match.
Preston waiting for his opponent. Preston grabs his leg, gets him down. Will he pin him this time? 1:40 left on the clock.
To take down for Preston Weaver.
I mean, 1:30 left on the clock. Preston desperately trying to pin his opponent again.
Preston now he's really trying to put him on his back, pull him around.
Not a lot of fight left from his opponent.
Looks like just his opponent's just getting super tired. And Preston's not having it. He's putting up a fight.
Oh, his opponent's
now
getting up.
Try
his
to
opponent's
drive
about
it.
To escape. His opponent escapes.
But with one, about 1 minute left, it's still 6-2. It'll be kind of hard. It'll be very hard for his opponent to finish him. And his opponent just threw him to the mat.
40 seconds left. His opponent gets Preston Weaver in a headlock. He escapes.
Preston escapes.
27 seconds left in this match, ladies and gentlemen.
And it is 7-4.
His opponent goes for the legs. Preston gets him in a headlock, trying to take him down. 15 seconds for him to pin.
Preston just takes two takedown with 10 seconds left.
The parents are going.
He's incredibly close to getting his opponent into a cradle with 5 seconds left in the match.
Two.
One.
That's match.
Preston Weaver finishes the match and wins with 9-4.
Very good match, Preston Weaver.
Preston Weaver's last home duel match. He definitely put up a good fight, and he definitely stayed in it till the end.
Next up is Roger Meyer. He's a sophomore at Vista, and it's his first year on varsity.
Is there anything you could tell him about us? Is he fast? Is he, well?
Roger's super determined. He's definitely a leader, to say the least, on and off the mat. He's incredibly determined and very quick on his feet.
He's not a quitter, then, I would assume.
He is not a quitter. He's a leader, and he's a fighter. Even if he loses, he fights until the last second.
There's some of that fast footwork right now, and even his arms are really fast.
Mm-hmm.
His opponent goes for the legs. He's able to completely dodge his opponent's move. Both opponents in a stalemate, fighting for control. Once again, he dodges his opponent's attempt to go for his legs. He now
Roger's
goes for
going
his legs.
For the leg, and
both opponents once again in a stalemate, fighting for control.
Roger shoots for the single leg and attempts a takedown. He's almost there.
His opponent's struggling to get back on him. He just has complete control over his leg.
Roger's got control. He just needs to trip him, and now he's got the takedown. Legend guy wasn't on top. He was just to the side, in an equal position.
Once again, opponents control. Well, we see Roger go for that leg again. That's been his favorite move so far this match. 20 seconds left on the clock. Seconds left, both opponents still fighting for control. Roger once again goes for that leg.
Roger goes for the single leg.
1 second, that's time.
After his opponent shows up, or top.
As you can tell, I'm not very well rehearsed in my terminology.
I gotcha.
Rogers desperately trying not to get pinned by his opponent on top of him.
He's determined.
Like I said earlier, he's not a quitter. He's going to fight until he's forced down. Desperately trying for that escape.
Not right.
His opponent's trying to lock down his legs. Rogers about to escape. Oh, gets dragged back down by his opponent. Minute 10 seconds left on the clock. Rogers once again trying to escape from his opponent. His opponent just has a firm lock on his waist, and he's not letting go.
Yeah.
Rogers gets his legs underneath him, trying to get his opponent's grip off of him.
Seconds left.
Rogers desperately trying to get his opponent's grip off him.
Roger's almost there. He's
Roger
almost down.
Roger gets to his feet, is dragged back down by his opponent. His opponent's grip will just not break on his waist.
Roger just Almost scored two. Roger just scored the reversal on his opponent.
Roger trying to pin his opponent.
With 1 second.
That's time. Both coaches talking to their players. Current
Green
score.
Green cheese is neutral.
Current score, Mountain Vista 21 points, Legend 24.
Roger's about to take the double leg once again. Or, not once again.
Roger's desperately going for that leg. Bittler desperately yelling to Rogers.
It's hard to hear with the headgear. That's why.
Once again, both opponents are in a stalemate. Legend goes for Roger's leg. Roger takes control. Just take a second to fix their headgear. Legend tries to go for the leg again. Roger's able to dodge it.
Roger can grab his legs right now.
Roger with
it.
A minute left on the clock trying to pin his opponent. Both are fighting for control. Roger trying to get up, but his opponent just has a firm lock on his legs.
Thank you. Roger's almost got the takedown. He just needs to move.
27 seconds left on the clock. Roger's trying for that pin. His opponent almost escapes. Roger's got a hold of his back left leg.
Roger gets two takedown.
He is
determined. With 10 seconds left, he needs to get one more point in order to win.
5 seconds. Will Roger pin him? That's match. Legend wins the match.
Eric Platts is right now filling. Roger right now is filling in for Braden Monk, who's out with a torn ACL. And right now, Garrick, who's on the JV team, is taking Roger's place in the 138 weight class.
Braden was actually supposed to commentate with us tonight, but could not do it, so shout out to him. Hope that his leg gets better. Both opponents fighting for control. The stalemate. Both of them are dancing around the ring.
Garrett.
Garrick fighting for control with his opponent. Garrick goes for the leg. His opponent sitting on top of him. Neither of them are in pin, but they're both fighting for control. Legend trying to fight for control.
Garrick is almost to the takedown.
1 minute left on the clock.
Uh-huh.
start in the neutral position. Both fighting for control over their opponent. Garrett goes for the leg. Both opponents fighting for control once again in the neutral position. Score 30 seconds left.
Garrick.
Legend has Garrick in headlock.
Not quite. Still in a neutral position. Oh, never mind.
10 seconds left. Legend desperately trying to pin Garrick. 3 seconds. That is match. Players fighting for control. Both players fighting for a good grip on their opponents. Legend gets Garrett down on the ground. Legend desperately trying to pin Garrick. Garrick fighting to get out of the situation. Garrick is stuck on the ground, but he is not pinned. Legend is desperately trying to pin him. Garrick is fighting for escape. 57 seconds left on the clock.
Garrick was almost out of that position.
Garrick trying to escape. His opponent only has control over his right leg.
He needs to get that grip off of his leg.
Garrick starting in the down position. Garrick fighting to escape his opponent's control over his back. 30 seconds left. Garrick trying to escape. Seconds. That is match. An update on the score for you: 21 Mountain Vista, 27 Legend.
In order for Garrick to score here, he needs to be quick on his feet, which he usually is. He just needs to be quicker than his opponent.
That is true. His opponent definitely seems to have his footwork down tonight. He's definitely giving Garrick a good match because they both seem to be very equal in their speed.
Garrett's almost in the takedown position.
Garrick trying to pin his opponent. Trying to escape his opponent's hold on him. Minute 15 left in the match.
His opponent needs to take off his headgear, else he's going to choke.
That is true. His opponent's headgear is slipped back around his neck and onto the back of his head.
Yeah, usually it just slips forward. I rarely see it come around his neck.
I've never even seen the headgear come behind someone's head like that. Legend takes a moment to fix his headgear. Very good decision.
That's a At some point, the ref has to call it because then it's a danger to the other person because they're so dehydrated. Like, they get choked. Garrick thumbs out, and there it is.
Garrick fighting for control with his opponent. Opponent gets on top of him. 30 seconds left. Garrick once again on the ground from his opponent.
10 seconds. Here you go.
5 seconds. Both opponents.
Do something.
Legend wins that match. Garrick didn't seem to put up much of a fight in the last minute of that match.
At the end, there's not much you can do, really.
If
you're in that tough of a position, it's really hard to do anything.
He definitely did seem like he was getting tired, too. He did fight very well in the beginning of the match, but it just seemed like his tiredness was getting to him.
Nolan Strichko at 145 pounds. Nolan Strichko is 15th in the state in his weight class.
You can definitely tell that, too. You can notice how he's fast on his feet and how he's quick to gain control over his opponent.
He's been wrestling for years, and so is that. So is his family. It's a tradition in his family.
He's fighting desperately for control with his opponent, though his opponent just won't let him grab control.
Nolan's close, though.
His opponent goes for his legs. Oh. Nolan's able to keep control over his opponent, though.
Legend goes for a single leg, and Nolan is about to take the takedown.
Nolan's got his opponent in a headlock, trying to get him on the ground.
All he has to do is get around.
Both players desperately trying to get their opponent on the ground. Nolan is definitely aware of his feet, and he's very aware of his opponent's trying to go for it. He tries to go for the headlock, misses. His opponent grabs control of his arm. Underhook. 40 seconds left in the match. Nolan trying to grab control over his opponent. Both of them are dancing around the
Nolan
ring.
Nolan takes two takes.
Twenty seconds left in the match. Thirteen seconds left in the match. We'll see where they take this. Five seconds. Nolan and his opponent don't manage to pin each other. Definitely both are fast on their feet, and it's interesting just trying to watch them fight for control over each other. Legend is starting in the down position. Update on that score for you, 21 Mountain Vista, 31 Legend. Nolan gets his opponent on the ground, trying to pin him. His opponent desperately trying to get back up. Nolan takes control over his feet with his own legs, trying to force his opponent's arms and his chest onto the mat.
His opponent's working hard to try to regain control, but it's not seeming to work for him.
Nolan goes for the headlock, trying to force his opponent onto the mat. His opponent tries to escape. Nolan desperately trying to get control again. Gets him in a headlock. Yes. Both players are back on their feet once again, fighting for control. Nolan gets his opponent
Nolan
back
just
onto
threw
the ground.
Him to the ground, and he's right now in a headlock with him.
1 minute left on the clock.
His opponent's pinned. Come on.
Nolan, what looks like a pin to us, but the ref does not want to call it. His opponent once again trying to get back up on his feet. Nolan just trying to force him down.
That was a pin right there, but he didn't even start calling it.
Nolan once again gets his opponent onto the ground.
All he has to do is tee out more in order to get the pin. And what's it look
That's a pin with 28 seconds left. Nolan wins that match. Update on the score for you. 27 Mountain Vista, 31 Legend.
John Urban is a sophomore at Vista. This is his second year wrestling. Yeah,
for the school
year.
At least.
For the school. And Legend has already taken the takedown.
He's definitely able to fight to get control over his opponent, even when he's on the ground with his opponent like that. His opponent has a firm lock on his waist, though, which he's going to have to try to break. He's trying to force himself back up again. He gets his knees underneath him. We'll see if he's able to get himself out of this position. Shoved back down onto the mat by his opponent. His opponent holding his arm behind his back and holding onto his waist. John can just not seem to get his opponent's grip off of him. He's desperately trying to get back up or even slip away from his opponent.
He also has his left arm trapped, but he was almost there with the reverse.
He just got his left arm free. Minute left on the clock. They get up for a split second, only for John to be taken back down by his opponent. John gains control over him. Opponent quickly takes back control and forces him back down onto the ground. John has his right arm free, but his left arm is stuck underneath him, grabbed by his opponent. Legend desperately trying to pin John, but John is just fighting till the very end. 15 seconds left, ladies and gentlemen. John is fighting. He has not let his opponent once try to pin him. He has been on the ground now. That was the buzzer. Both opponents will reset. Legend starting in the down position. John tries to go for that leg. His opponent desperately trying to spin around and pin him instead. John
Legend
once again the on
reverse.
The ground. John once again trying to just fight to slip away from his opponent. His opponent trying to trap his right arm. Minute 30 left. Ref waiting for that pin. John desperately trying to escape. His legs are free. Desperately trying to get free, his opponent just has a grip around his arm and his head. Minute 4 left. Mountain Vista starting in the neutral position with Legend. minute left. Once again, John is on the ground. I've seen a recurring pattern this whole match. John once again trying to break his opponent's grip on his waist and upper arm. Left. John once again trying to escape from his opponent. He has both his arms free currently. His opponent trying to regain his grip on him. That is match, ladies and gentlemen. Legend starting in down position.
John throws him to the mat.
Trying to take his opponent down. His opponent quickly
gets John.
But Legend
pulls a reversal once again.
Grayson, if you were able to give any advice to John right now, what would you tell him?
I would tell him to just keep on fighting and try to break this guy's grip.
He's definitely got a fighting spirit. Not once have I seen him just give up when he's going to his grandma.
Oh, no. Like all these wrestlers, he's a huge fighter. Throughout every match, no matter what, he pushes through. Because he wants to win. He desires to be the best.
Both opponents shake hands. That's the end of that match. Score update for you, 27 Mountain Vista, 37 Legend.
At 160 pounds, Golden Eagle, Kennedy William, Cameron William, Titans wrestler, Titans Ring.
Both players quick on their feet, but Legend desperately going for his leg.
Anders
on the ground.
I think out of all of the wrestlers so far from here to now, I think Anders is the one that's grown the most. He used to be not that good last year as a freshman, but conditioning. Throughout practice, constantly, he's on his back. He's really improved compared to last season.
That's good to know. You can definitely see it in him. He's been able to fight with control of his opponent, or even at the beginning of this match, the two of them were just fighting to get control over each other, and they were just dancing around the ring. You could really see his speed. Minute 5 left on the clock.
Thank you.
we're just waiting now for the ref. We're going to spray part of the mat.
Very exciting part of the mat.
Most excitement we've seen all night.
Kidding. Preston Weaver's match was really good.
Preston Weaver's match was definitely one of the most eventful of the night.
Mm-hmm.
Anders starting in down position. Legend gets him in a headlock almost immediately. A minute left on the clock. Still has him in that headlock. He's desperately trying to get out of it.
Not even a single shoulder blade was on. Okay, now he can start counting it.
Legend once again wins another match. I will admit, even though I do go to Mount Vista, that was very impressive on Legend's part. Just that headlock, the speed that he got him down. Update on the score for you, 27 Mount Vista, 43 Legend. Let me ask you this, what do you think is one of the most important attributes to have as a wrestler?
I think a lot has to do with like the legitimate skills of like being a good wrestler and the muscle behind it, physicality behind it. But I feel like a lot, the most of it is not only support from your teammates, because it, even though it seems like an individual sport, I've heard from a lot of wrestlers that it's actually a team sport. Like the support that the entire team gives each other is truly extraordinary, and how they coach on the sideline, there for every match. And I also think personally, determination and leadership is a huge quality of being an excellent wrestler, like Cameron Williams, and the ability to change, like Cameron Williams and like Anders. They've grown a lot over the past year.
Do you think the motivation from their teammates has helped them grow as well? It's encouraged them?
Yes, definitely. And I feel like a lot of them aspire to be like their teammates, such as the seniors this year and the seniors last year. They were excellent wrestlers. And they've been doing it for a long, long time.
Both wrestlers once again fighting for control. 45 seconds left. Both wrestlers fix their headgear. Both fighting for control. Not a lot of movement from them, just showing that they are both desperately fighting to gain control of the other's upper body. Desperately trying to get out of the headlock, his opponent has him in. He goes for his legs. He gets
Cameron
his opponent on the ground.
Oh.
His opponent quickly gets back up. 4 seconds left. And that's a match. I'll tell you one thing I've noticed just with wrestling tonight, too, is that one of the most physically fit people I see out here tonight is the ref. Wouldn't you agree?
Most of the time, the refs are pretty good at their job. There are just a couple refs that I can actually hit in my head. I'm like, oh, are you kidding me? That ref is here. You've got to be kidding me.
I'll tell you, I can relate to that too. Even when I played lacrosse, everyone just has those moments with refs.
And you're like, you've got to be kidding me.
The main thing, though, especially for the wrestlers like they are right now in the ring, you just have to sort of ignore the ref and can't let them get into your mind.
Yeah.
Ooh, he
Cameron takes
the
takedown.
Minute 30 left. Will he pin his opponent? Minute 29 left on the clock. Legend starting in the down position. once again trying to gain control over his opponent. Injury. It looked like he took an elbow to the chin there. Both the trainer and Coach Whitler are out on the mat. Looks like he just took a really hard elbow. Tell us about this injury. Let me ask you a question. How often do you normally see injuries during these matches?
During matches?
During matches, not practice.
They're less frequent than in practice, I think for sure. A lot of the time, just even with each other, they're rougher.
That must have been hard. I just heard Coach Fittler. Feels dizzy.
Oh, God.
Could possibly be a concussion. I've had a couple of lifetime just from the cross. If he does feel dizzy and the light is starting to bother him, he definitely has a concussion. The parents are trying for him to get back up, but if he feels dizzy, he really should not continue. What you will, he is a fighter.
Oh, yes.
Minute 20 left on the clock.
Cameron almost takes the takedown with the single leg.
Fifty-six seconds left on the clock. Forty seconds left on the clock. Both opponents just fighting for control again.
Legend guy's getting tired, and it's only a minute 30 into the second period.
I completely agree. Legend just seems to be slowing down. 20 seconds left. Both opponents just fighting for control. 15 seconds. Ref wants Legend to fix his headgear. Sends him out of this one. If only we could see Cam hold the headlock that we just saw Legend pull in the final seconds of their match not too long ago. 10 seconds. He goes for the leg.
Go, single leg.
3 seconds.
That's two.
Coach Bittler challenging the ref. We understand what happened there. Would you like to elaborate?
Second time. Okay. It was clearly during the match that Cameron threw him down and was in a dominating position against him. Oh my God, are you kidding me? It was clear, but the ref refuses to admit it for the second time, so he's not going to call it.
Just to brighten up the mood a little bit, I did hear one of the parents shout out technique to Cam, and all I could think of was this SpongeBob quote, technique.
Technique.
Minute 45 on the clock. Both players once again in a stalemate, just fighting for that control over one another. Coach Bittler watching angrily from the sidelines.
Mm-hmm. Cameron's just gonna, he's just gotta go for it. And he needs to drive his opponent back into the circle, first of all. And now he can drive it. Go!
Cameron
two!
Has control over his opponent.
Now he's in a pinning position.
Cameron's opponent's headlock is desperately trying just to pin him right now. The ref will not call it.
Now the guy's on his back.
Minute left on the clock. Will he pin him?
Cameron's just got to tee out a little bit more to call it.
Woo! Woo! That's a pin for Mountain Vista. Quite amazing. Just to see Cam come back from that injury and just win the pin. Beautiful. Update on that score for you. 33 Mountain Vista, 43 Legend.
And should I? I'm out.
Thank you everyone for your attendance tonight. I am once again Jake Torres, my commentator.
Grayson Poinson.
And we would just like to thank you. Thank you for tuning in tonight and watching this amazing match. Legend did end up winning tonight, but that is not, but we did see beautiful plays from people such as Preston Weaver. And once again, good night, ladies and gentlemen, and good luck.